Now the fun really begins. This is number 14, and we see a transformation, and we have to incorporate this into the original function. We have to see what happened to this function. Remember, anything that happens in moving an x value happens inside the parentheses. Anything that would move a y value happens outside the function. So we're going to take a look at this. This is the x we're working with. So to set up the new function that we're going to get, so we have f and then we've got this new function, we're going to take h of x. And what's that going to look like? Well, there's going to be something squared. That's going to be, and anything, it could just be x, but we'll see. This is whatever happened to the x. We're going to do that. What's happening to the y happens out here. And just like we did on the last one, we find a good point to focus on, and this vertex is a very important one. We can see the graph itself appears to just be getting moved over. It's about the same width and everything. What we can see, though, is that it's getting moved. Let's go with maybe, let's see if will yellow work good. It's getting moved down. Maybe you can't see that very well. Looks like down 3, that's affecting a y, right? And then over 2. So I guess maybe let's go with black will work. So we went down 3, that's going to affect the y values, and then over positive 2. Okay, so inside, this is what we'll deal with first, is remember it's always backwards. To move in the positive 2 direction, what we're going to want to do is have x minus 2. That will affect this moving over by 2. And maybe you think, well, it's inside, let's do that first. Okay, we could do that first. And then the second thing that happens is come down by 3. When you're outside, you just do what you need to do. So we see that it went down 3, so we subtract 3. That's all there is to it. You don't have to FOIL this out. You don't have to simplify it in any ways. It's all good. Okay, and now when I go down here, let's see. I'm going to put my parentheses, x minus 2. I guess I'll go up a little bit, but then all my drawings go off, but that's okay. X minus 2, and don't forget the square, because that's part of the function. Arrow over, and then now let's subtract 3. So notice how the x is backwards of how you would think of it. Think of looking into a mirror. That's how you go into a function. Everything is backwards. When you're outside, you get what you see. So we went down 3, that's a negative 3. We went to the right, we went in the positive direction 2. That's why we have a negative 2 on the inside. And that's our function there. And I think that's all we got. Let's see. Yeah, just one question this time. So there's the picture. We'll clear the drawings off. And that is number 14.